Hello everyone, this is Manoj. In today's video, we will learn how we can create a CRUD operation in React application. Means how we can insert, delete and update data in React application. So for that, let me open my command prompt. Now let me navigate to D drive because I want to create the React application in D, and in D let me create a folder React CRUD, and now let me navigate to this folder, and now let me create our React application by writing the command npx create React app, and let me give the name like React hyphen CRUD. Okay, so it will create a React-CRUD application, and it will install all the required file and folders and other dependencies. So it will take some time because it has to install all the file and folders and also the node modules and other stuff. So let's wait for a while. Once it gets completed, then we'll move further. So it is about to finish. Let's wait some more time. So here it is, we have created our React app. So now let me navigate to this folder. So we are in the folder. So now let's open this React-CRUD React application into our Visual Studio Code. So if you don't have Visual Studio Code in your machine, then download it from internet, and then we have to write a command code space dot, hit enter. So it will open this React application in Visual Studio. So you can see, so this is our folder structure, node modules, public, source folder. These are other files. This is our initial welcome file. So let me close it. So now let's go to this source folder. So you can see we have app.css, app.js and also other files. So let me open, first of all, let me app.js. So this is our initial created file, and let me also run the application. For that we have to go terminal, new terminal, and here we have to write npm start. Okay, so it will start our development server and it will render all this stuff on our default browser. So I'm using Google Chrome as a default browser, so it will render all the content on Google Chrome. You can see. And there is another thing, localhost colon 3000. So 3000 is our default port in React. If you want, you can go and change it, but by default you will get as 3000. All right. So now we have to make some changes on this app.js. All right. So first of all, let me delete all this. Now let's write some code. Like import, let me port React comma component from React, and now we have to create a class based component. For that we have to write class name which extends the component. In our class component, let me first write export default app. All right, we have to export it. So now let me call constructor first. In our constructor, we have to write super, we have to call it. And now at initial level, we are declaring our state, which is, for example, we are taking a employee example. So let me write employee data as blank array. All right, after constructor, and now we have our render method. and in render we will return a simple div. Let's say hello world. Save. Go to browser. You can see. Now, let me remove this div because we don't want it. And let me give a form. And let me use ref as a title or as a unique value, like we are using IDs in jQuery. So let me give my form. And inside the form, let me have a label that is for name. And for name, let me also take an input field that would be a text field. And ref would be txt name and also a placeholder like enter name. Another one is age. Also a text field. And ref would be txt age and a placeholder enter age. Alright. And now also a button, save. So now let me save it. Go to our browser. You can see we have name and age. Alright. So first of all, let me create a onClick of this button. OnClick. So onClick we'll have a function this dot handle submit. So let me create handle submit. That would be a arrow function. E dot prevent default. And here, first of all, let me take let employee data is equal to this dot state dot employee data. And now let me take a variable like name, and that would be this dot refs dot txt name dot value. Okay, so again this dot refs dot txt age dot value. So we have taken both the values. Now employee data dot, let me take another variable like add let new employee, and name would be name, and age would be age. So now employee data dot push new employee. Now we have to reset the state of employee data. This dot set state employee data is our updated employee data. Alright. And after that, let me reset the form. So this dot refs dot my form, that is the ID of form, reset. right? So let me save it. Let's go to browser. No error. Great. And now in the render folder we have to take let employee data is equal to this dot state dot employee data, and after the form control let me take a table and we will write all the data whatever is inside this object. So first of all let me create table, and after that let me create a tr and th. One is for name and second one is for age. All right, let me also put a div, otherwise it will throw error. All right, now after this tr let me create. So we have our this employee data object. So we will use employee data dot map function. All right. So inside this map, let me take data and index, and that will generate our tr. So let me create tr first. And inside our tr, let me give tr a unique value. For that we'll use key as I, because that would be unique. And inside this tr let me take first td for name. So here we will write data dot name. Let me copy this, paste it here. So let me change it for age. All right, so let me save it. Now go back to browser. No issues, these are coming as a table header. So let's run it. For example, a age 10, save. Cannot read property txt age of undefined. Let me check where it is saying. Oh, my mistake. This dot refs. Let's save again. And now let's say ABC 10. You can see we have a record ABC 10 XYZ 20. Save. We are getting our records. Great. So now let me also take two buttons here, one for edit, one for delete. So button edit, let me take another td, and button delete. All right, and let me also declare on click events for these both. This dot handle edit, and here we'll pass I as an index. All right, so let me copy this event and paste for delete button also, and let me change the event handle delete. All right, save it. Now go back to our function and let's create first handle delete. So that is all, that would also a arrow function. Here we are receiving index from the table. So now for delete, first let employee data, let's get the employee object first. This dot state dot employee data, and now employee data dot splice. It will delete whatever index you will pass and the number. So I'm passing I comma 1. It means it will go to that particular index and it will delete that record. All right. So now, after deleting the record from this employee data object, we'll reset our object. So this dot set state. So employee data is our new updated data. All right. So let me save it for now. Okay. Let me create it first. Handle added. Okay, let's take it blank as of now. Let me add some values. So our buttons are coming now. So let me delete this one first. So 20 is deleted. This is also deleted. Awesome. Let me add some more values. So our adding part and deleting part both are working. So let's work for added. For added, let me also take a title over here, like title my React app, and let me come here and let's take a h1. And this dot state dot title, save, go back. Okay, so now for edit we have to take some more variables, like one is act. At initial level we are setting it 0, and index as blank. All right. So now in edit, let's have the employee data from this dot state dot employee data, and let me pass I. So it will give me the exact particular record which we are going to edit. So now we have that record. So now this dot refs.txt name dot value is equal to employee data dot name, and again for age refs.txt age dot value is equal to employee data dot age. Okay, so now after that, let me change the state also. Set state. So employee data is equal to new updated employee data. All right. And we have to change act as 1. Fine. Also, we have taken index. Yes. So index as I. Okay. Let me save it. Okay. First of all, let's go back to handle submit. And now we have to check before this if this dot state dot act is equal to 0. Means that is a new record. For that we have to take this and paste it here. All right. And else, let employee data equal to this dot state dot employee data. And now employee data, and we are passing index because we have the updated index dot name equal name, whatever we are getting from the text box, and again employee data index dot age equal age. And here let me change the act as 0. So save it. So here we need to take index this dot state dot index. So now let's try it. Let's add this one. Alright, so values are coming as per the current index. So let's add this bb underscore cc. Save. You can see we are able to edit our records. Let me again edit it, and let's say 50. You can see. So now our application is working whatever we were expecting at the beginning. So let's alright, so now let's go back and design this application. Okay, so go to our app.css, and I have already some ready made the style sheets. So let me just copy and paste over here just to save time. And now go back to our app.js, and let me give the names like form class name my form, and our text fields name class name as form field. Then copy properly, and also let me copy this for the age field, and we also have class for button. So let me go and write the class for button. Let me copy this and also give these buttons. Alright, so let's go back. Okay, let me import it. Import slash app.css. Save. Back to browser. You can see a form has been rendered. Let me copy this title and put it inside the form. Save. So this is coming here. Let's write some style for this table. Go to app.css and let's write dot table like background color. This and width, let's say 50%, and let's make it center margin 0 auto. Let me save it, and let's go back and provide a class name table. Let's save it. Go back to browser. let me add some value. You can see, and just to make the content center, go to app.css, text align center, save it, go to browser, you can see. And let me also give heading for these buttons, like th, that is added, and another one is delete. Let's go back. Okay, now you can see so let me edit this one and write underscore mm-aa or sorry underscore. So delete is working. Let me delete this second one. Div is deleted. So this is our complete insert, delete, update, like a CRUD operation in React. So that's it for the day. I hope you liked the video, and if you did so, hit the like button, share and comment. And if you haven't subscribed my channel, go and subscribe so that whenever I post this kind of videos which would be useful for you, you will get the notification at the earliest. So see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye. Thanks for the watching.